I wanted to begin the book with some kind of conclusion of the armistice. And this clergyman, I think he was a rector of Margate, had seen at the Western Front a battered sort of signs, said something like, "The Unknown Soldier," something like that. And when he got to the emotion when the war finally ended with millions killed and the desolation, and it was so appalling, no one knew quite what to do and how to celebrate it. And Lutyens designed the cenotaph, which is a Greek idea of an empty tomb for London. And then everybody had lost somebody, millions. Absolutely, the whole thing was shocking and disgraceful, really. And they had these promises about, you know, homes for heroes, all ridiculous. In 1923 began the great, you know, sort of depression. And people walking about in the streets in London selling matches who'd been in the Western Front with their medals hanging on their shoulders. When I went to Westminster Abbey Library, I was given a shoebox by the librarian with all the letters about this idea. And King George V was, first of all, rather shocked by it and thought it sensational. And then he came round to it. And then this whole process began of finding the body. And something like, I can't remember the details, but six bodies were dug up from various battlefields in France and put in this shed, like a Nissen hut, before Nissen huts really, and all anonymous. And a young officer, I think, was blindfolded and taken, and he put his hand on one of them, that's the one. And then they had a job finding a place in Westminster Abbey which didn't have previous burials. Over 3,000 people, I think, they said, had been buried in the Abbey at different times. Anyway, they found them. There's one near the entrance, which went down into the sands of the island on which the Abbey is built in the Thames. And King George then became fascinated by that. And he had his own sword pinned to the coffin of the unknown warrior. And I think in 1920, the whole of London stopped, as it were, and people wore black, and there was an enormous procession, and this unknown soldier was treated like son of the king or son, taken and buried in Westminster Abbey. And this, the dean had worked out rather fulsome, very elaborate tombstone, which is there now. Although at the beginning they were going to have very simple wording on it, but the dean, long inscription is on the top. And it somehow was a symbolic conclusion to the horrors of the war.